It is a property of the liquid. Okay. Before taking the definition of the surface tension, I will explain what are the cohesive forces and what are the adhesive forces. These cohesive forces and adhesive forces are molecular attractive forces. So these are the attraction between molecules. So here, if the attraction between the molecule of the same liquid, it is called cohesive force. Means in the container, let us assume I am taking some water. If the attraction between two molecules of the same liquid is called cohesive force. Okay, so according, if you see the definition here, cohesive forces means molecular attraction between the molecules of the same liquid. Okay, in the surface tension, I will explain how the cohesive forces will come in between the molecules in the surface tension. So before taking the definition of the surface tension, I will give one example here. Here in one container, I am taking liquid. Okay, in this liquid, I am taking A, B, C molecules. A molecule is only half part is in the liquid. B molecule 3/4 part is in the liquid. And C is completely in the liquid. Just now I told cohesive forces will occur between the molecules of the same liquid. Okay, so all the molecules will subjected to forces, attractive forces. Those are called cohesive forces. Okay, let us take the first one. Okay, it is half in it. Now I am taking half of the particle like this. So it is surrounding with the, again, molecules of the liquid like this. Got it? Like this. Okay. Now because of these molecules, it has attractive forces. Okay, between the molecules. So these attractive forces are like this. This is one attractive force because of this adjacent molecule. Here, one more like this. All attractive forces. Because of this, whatever resultant, resultant means sum of all these forces, is going coming in the downward direction. Resultant is in the downward direction. Because of the downward force, resultant force, this A molecule will try to come in downward direction. Got it? And this will come, try to come in downward direction because resultant is resultant in downward direction. And here, so molecule will also coming in downward direction, try to come in downward direction. So all these molecular forces in the container will try to come at the center of the liquid. Center of the liquid, let us assume this is the center of the liquid. All molecules will try to come at the center of the liquid. Let us take the B liquid. B is 3/4 inside the liquid. Okay. It is also surrounding to the molecules. Okay. Like this. So because of the cohesive forces, the attraction will be there between this molecule and B, between this molecule and B, like that. For this also, forces are acting downward because of other molecules, cohesive forces. So the final resultant will coming in downward direction. B also try to come in downward direction. So because resultant is downward, it will also try to come in downward direction, B also. Downward direction means all A and B will try to come at the C, center of the liquid. Always remember, this is the important point. All the particles will try to come at the center of the liquid. Okay. Now take the C liquid, C molecule. So C also surrounding with the molecules. Okay. Here, if you are taking C here, C molecule. So the it is surrounded, it is symmetrical, surrounding with the whatever this side molecules number is equal to the same number of molecules downward. So attractive forces are like this, symmetrical. Whatever forces this side also same force. Whatever forces this side also same force. So it will remain as it is. It is staying at this position only, C position only. Okay. So this is an example for defining the surface tension. What I am trying to say is, whatever surface particles are there, all will try to come in the downward direction. Okay, whatever molecules we are taking, all will try to come at the center of the liquid, like this. Okay, so this surface is subjected to tension. Okay, this is called surface tension. So definition of the surface tension. So it is defined as a tensile force. Okay, tensile force acting on the surface of a liquid. Okay, it is a tensile force acting on the surface of the liquid. Because of cohesive forces. Okay, so this is called surface tension. We are using the symbol for surface tension, okay, sigma. So is it possible to find the formula for surface tension? That is sigma. Okay, so here what we are giving definition, it is a tensile force. Let us assume this is L meter. Okay, length of this container or width is L meter. For L meter length, a force is acting, tensile force. Let us assume like that. We have to always calculate for 1 meter how much tensile force is acting. Okay, so we can write 1 by L into F, that is F by L means force by length. Force by length is called surface tension. So this is F is tensile force. What are the units for this? For force, as we know, newtons. Length means meters, newton by meter, units are. Okay. Now here the entire surface is subjected to tension. It is called surface tension. How to find out surface tension means force divided by this length will give the surface tension. An example I give for surface tension. If I am pouring water on the surface, okay, so it will try to get in, instead of flowing fluid, it will try to get like this. Okay, it will shrink. Okay, water will shrink. So sometimes it is getting in the form of droplet or spherical shape. Why it is coming like this means whatever boundary, at the boundary particles are there, molecules, because of cohesive forces or surface tension, all will try to come at the center of this liquid. Okay, so here also like this, because of cohesive forces it will try to shrink. So I will give one example also practically. So all will try to come at the center so that it is getting the in the form of spherical shape. Okay, so why the liquid droplet is in the form of sphere means because of surface tension, it is trying to get the minimum area. So if you are taking these two areas, it has the minimum area, sphere has. Because of cohesive forces, it is getting the spherical shape. Okay, so in next example, I will show you this, why this will shrink because of surface tension. So here, what is the use of this property, surface tension? So here, if you are seeing bigger ships and boats are floating on the water surface because of tensile force or surface tension on the surface of the liquid, and lotus flowers also floating on the water surface. So this is the main, these are the main uses for floating purpose. This ship should have some flat surface, and this has the flat surface area. At the time only it may try to move, otherwise it is coming downward. Okay. So here if we can observe some mosquitoes or some insects are also flowing on the water, we can see the surface tension example in those places.